A warm good morning to all of you. I welcome you all to the social class, specially to the history one, because we are in the fourth chapter of our history book. In yesterday's class, you had got an idea of manuscript, handwritten notebook, okay? And the manuscript were copied by the scribes. The group of people were known as what? Scribes. And also you have known the idea of Rajput. The word Rajput came from Rajaputra, son of the rulers. There were also other groups of people in the society like the Maratha, Jats, Ahoms and so on. But Rajput were the people who were the rulers also. Also the soldiers basically belongs to the Kshatriya caste and the people who used to work in the armed force. So they were Rajput. Now today you will know about Jatis. Emergence of Jatis. Now how these Jatis were emerged in the society, you will know. Clearing of forest. With the passage of time for extension of agriculture, forests were cleared, and when forests were cleared, there were also people who used to live in the forest, and they were known as forest dwellers. Their habitat changed. Now, what do you mean by the word habitat? Habitat means a certain environment of a particular area where people used to live, and when the habitat changed, the social and economic lifestyle of that particular people also changed, isn't it? In Chapter 1 of Geography Book, Environment, I hope you remembered. You have known this, isn't it? Ecosystem. A particular ecosystem depends on the area where the people, animals used to live. And ecosystem varies with place to place. So, habitat, that means the environment of the forest dwellers, the people who used to live in the forest, change with clearance of forest. Why this clearing of forest was done? Because to extend agriculture, okay? When the clearing of forest occurred, the forest dwellers started tilling the land, or you can say cultivating in the land, and became peasants, okay? They became what? Peasants. Slowly and gradually, they started influencing the society and became part of the large complex society. This forest dwellers who became new peasants, after that slowly and gradually they became part of the complex society. But with the passage of time, their economic status also changed. Some peasants had large area of land, okay, so they were rich. Some peasants had a cattle and small area of land, they were not so rich. Some peasants used to earn their livelihood through agriculture as well as artisanal works. So in this way, people, with regards of their occupation, there were certain division. Okay, now this division became more and more with the passage of time. So this division only created jatis or subcastes, you can say. This difference of the people in the society on the basis of their economic and social status created jatis or subcaste. Now how with the regards of their occupation they were further divided, we will know that. But first of all, there are how many of castes in the Indian society, in the ancient Indian society? In class 6 you read that according to the occupation, Varna system, I hope you remember, people were divided, okay? There were 4 castes, and they were Brahmanas, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas and Shudras. But now with the emergence of this forest dwellers becoming new peasants, and division on the basis of their occupation, there were certain division basis of their economics and social structure, there were divisions, and they were further divided into or grouped into jatis or subcastes. Now how these jatis or subcastes were also divided on the basis of their economic status, Huguenot. The passage of time, when the differentiation among this group of people became more and more, their economic and social status changed, these jatis were further grouped on the basis of their backgrounds and occupation. But their ranks were not permanently fixed. Why? Because their ranks might be changed. We never know. Today they are poor. In future they might be rich. Then their status will be changed. And with the change of the status, their ranks will also change. As a result, ranks were not fixed permanently. The status of the same jati could also vary from area to area. In this area, this particular jati were regarded as very much high. But in other area, they might be also low subcaste or low jatis. So, according to the place, according to the area, this status of jatis also change. Jatis form their own rules and regulations, okay? So, these jatis or the subcastes, they used to form their own rules and regulations to manage the conduct of their members. So, they used to form their own rules and regulations. So, how they were managed or manageable? They were manageable by their own members, okay? So, they were enforced by an assembly of elders. So, the people, the elderly people of this particular jatis or subcaste used to look after the whole system of jatis or subcaste. These jatis or elderly member of people, okay, of this jatis used to form a jati panchayat. And if something wrong will happen with the people of that particular jati, then he or she will go to the jati panchayat. The jati panchayat composed of the elderly people of that particular jati or subcaste. I hope you are clear with this. Jatis were also required to follow the rules of village. It doesn't mean that they were manageable or they were looked by the jati panchayat. They will not listen to the village authority. They also have to follow the rules and regulation of the villages, and they were ruled by the or governed by the chieftain. That means the village rules, village areas were governed by the chieftain, and they had to listen to the chieftain. But if they will find some kind of problem, then they will go to the jati panchayat. Then jati panchayat will further discuss the problem with the village authority, or you can say the chieftain. Then together they form one small unit of state, that the jati of, that means the subcaste, okay? This subcaste of people, they together form a small unit of state. That's all in the jati system. I hope you have enjoyed it and you understood. Actually, you know, this forest dwellers who became pigeons because they were changing their environment or habitat, they doesn't fix into the ideas of the Brahmanas, or doesn't fix in the Brahmanical ideas, okay? They doesn't fix in the Vedic tradition, okay? In the system of the Vedic tradition or the Varna system. That's why they were further subdivided into jatis or subcastes. We can say like that also. These jatis were grouped on the basis of their economic status. When these jatis, these pigeons, you can say, varies with time to time, their economic status also changed. Some are rich, some might be poor. So with their economic status, with their occupation, their jatis also changed. But the ranks of these jatis were not permanently fixed. Why? Because today they are poor. In future might be they become rich. When they will become rich, their jati will change. As a result, their ranks were not permanently fixed. The status of the same jati, okay, could vary from place to place. In this particular region, for example, in the Rajasthan region, this A jatis were considered as very much superior. But when they will go to the Madhya Pradesh region, this A jati might not be so much of superior, okay? So the status of the same jati also change with the place. Jatis formed their own rules and regulation, and they were managed by their elderly people, and their elderly people from the jati panchayat. But it doesn't mean that they doesn't listen to the village authority. They even listen to the village authority, but if they will face any kind of problem, they will go to the jati panchayat. Okay, and the jati panchayat will further discuss the problem with the village authority, and this you can say group of people together form a small unit of state. That's all. See you on Monday with our new topic. I hope you are clear in this. If you have any kind of queries, feel free to contact me. Thank you.